Ladies and gentlemen, now I got really carried away in Labyrinth of Legends or Guillotine 2099 just because I wanted to see what this champion was capable of and whether or not she would have the damage output to get down Wolverine X23 and also kind of how the matchup would look like and feel. If you're not already familiar with this fight, essentially Wolverine X23 is like the Labyrinth of Legends equivalent of Realm of Legends Wolverine. So there is a lot of regeneration on this fight. You have kind of attacking into Wolverine, but also every time that timer expires, there's going to be a really big flood of regeneration as well. However, with Guillotine 2099, you do have the ability to throw off the special 2, which is going to block out that regeneration and also reverse it by 20%. So it's not like the biggest regeneration reversal in the world, but it really does help to combat and mitigate a lot of regeneration in this fight. And alongside that, for every single hit, again, your direct damage is ramping up and up and up. So above like 100 hits, you're really starting to lay in and kind of out damage that regeneration passively, so it starts to become a really good time. But also we do want to end this fight in preparation for the next fight with a special 3 to make sure we start with 100 hits on the combo. Going in for a bit of a 5 combo here. I get very close to the special 3 just to kind of make a bit more of a push to try and get X23 down, because in the grander scheme of things, we haven't made too much of a dent so far. We've only got 15% down. She just got an evade there. Luckily we didn't get punished. We do have the safety net of the 2 combo shield charges from the heavy and also the 3 evade charges from the Nick Fury synergy as well, which is a pretty nice time. But we're just baiting out a special 2 here, not making too much headway at the moment, but now we're at a point where every single one of our hits is dealing approximately about 5,000 additional damage, and after that special 2 it's gone up a fair bit to about 6,000 per hit. So yeah, that damage, it really starts to skyrocket around this point, and this is where we can start making some proper headway against X23 here. Now overall, I think Guillotine is actually a really solid option for this fight. She's definitely one of the few champions that can just power through that regeneration, but I would say the best option is still Void. And if you don't have like a really good 5 or 6 star champion that can deal with this fight, just as a heads up, even a 4 star version of Void can take down this X23 as long as you can stay alive and get lucky with the kind of the petrifies applying early. Like, you can do a lot with the heal reversal, man. It's a very potent and very effective strategy, because I had to use, I believe it was a 4-star version of Guillotine at rank 4 back in the day, and this fight was a slog, man. It's really difficult to do a Guillotine as a 4-star champion, because you're going to be very, very aggressive, and yeah, you need to do it over several tries as well. So the old school Guillotine isn't really that great and super reliable for this fight, but the new Guillotine, man, is just absolutely awesome, because there is so much damage ramp up, and even if you were playing a 5-star version of this character, I assume at rank 4 as well, you would eventually have enough damage with a combo me to ramp up to out damage the regeneration, because Guillotine, she ramps up to 600 hits with her direct damage, so we are at only like 190 hits on the additional combo meter above 100, so there's a lot more damage output that we could be utilizing. But also at this point I have like enough damage per hit, because it's just over like 11,000 direct damage per hit at this point, that we don't really need to use the special 2 to kind of finish this off for a quick kill. However, if we really wanted to, we could, but the importance to a Guillotine, man, is to try and end every single fight on a special 3, just so you can start the next fight immediately with 100 hits on your combo meter. And the next fight being Venom, you know, I thought it was fairly essential to try and weave in a special 3 to finish this last off. So yeah, we're avoiding a special 2 here. We go for a 5 combo. Look at that, mate. 12,000 additional damage per hit. Absolutely beautiful there. We just need like a few more hits to get her down. There we go. 1%. We fire off a special 3. Interrupt that final killing blow. So 327 hits on the combo. We started with 100. So that was about like 227 overall. But the combo meter with the special 3 animation hits, I believe, is going to show 232 hits. Overall, just an absolutely fantastic performance there. Very clean, very efficient. So yeah, she's great for that matchup. And I think Guillotine is actually one of the few characters. I think it's only Guillotine and Aegon that can reliably take all of the corner bosses. I think Ghost might be able to as well. But I know Ghost can sometimes be a little bit shaky when it comes to the X23 matchup. But yeah, I think Guillotine, she's not really that optimal for the Spider-Man boss, but I think she would be able to do it, just because I remember doing the Spider-Man boss with like my 5-star rank 4 Star-Lord back in the day. So yeah, I think that's a really cool trait about the character, man, because it's always good to like get all 4 done in a single run if you can. But I would say, you know, I've said it in some of the other Labyrinth videos, like Aegon, at least in my opinion, is still the king of Labyrinth of Legends. But if Aegon is the king, I would say the Guillotine 2099 is probably the queen when it comes to Labyrinth of Legends. But I think we're certainly going to have to see when it does come to the Abyss of Legends as to, you know, which champion is going to be more useful and which champion is going to come out on top. One thing I have noticed is I think Kabam really enjoy like making their own character creations like a fair bit more overpowered than the average character, which, you know, kind of makes sense, man, because you think about some of the more old school characters that Kabam added in, like Venompool and Civil Warrior. I think Venompool like existed somewhere in like one of the Deadpool comics before he was added into the game, but he wasn't really like developed as a character. However, Civil Warrior, I think, is a Kabam original character, to the best of my knowledge and memory. Again, I may be slightly incorrect there, but I know like Aegon and Guillotine were, so they've definitely gone seemingly the extra mile to make those champions like extra spicy, extra exciting, and like everybody and their mum just wants a 6-star awakened version of Aegon. Like, he's such a phenomenal champion, and I feel like it's going to be a very similar story when it does come to the release of Guillotine 2099. And they have also mentioned that they are going to be pausing the champion rebalances. So I was going to do a video on that at some point, maybe later today if we do have the opportunity, but hopefully that means Guillotine 2099 is going to be safe from, you know, any changes. But speaking to some of the developers at Comic-Con and some of the QA team, they said they're actually very happy with where Guillotine 2099 was at as a character. Like, she's meant to be like this insanely powerful weapon if you can ramp her up, but obviously like she has a very big ramp up before she becomes like something really, really good. But you know, the special 3 and transferring the combo fight to fight, that really does help out the character a tremendous amount. So here we've been going up against Venom, man, and this is honestly, I think, the best Venom fight that I've ever had in Labyrinth of Legends, because usually Venom is like so passive, he's like never throwing any of his special attacks, and this one has been really, really generous using his special wands. So yeah, we've been having a great time in this matchup so far. 150 hits on our combo, and he's pretty much down to 25% almost now. So another 5 combo, I think at this point is where I'm like, oh, I should probably save up for a special 3. So yeah, I think I was a little bit tempted to use the special 2. It's always a little bit tempting just because there's so much burst damage on the special 2. You know it can just end the matchup, but if you end the matchup like that, the first 100 hits of the next matchup are going to be so slow, because 0 to 100 hits, man. She's not really that much of an impressive character. It's once you get in that 100 hits territory that you really do start to see the magic with Guillotine 2099. So yeah, every single one of our hits is dealing just over 9,500 direct damage there, going up to 10,000. So we just need like one more combo on Venom. So we land that final medium, get a quick parry, go for the dash back, special 3. Probably could have done that final medium chain straight onto special 3 there, but I think I wanted to be a little bit more safe in this matchup. But yeah, that was a beautiful matchup. We also managed to finish with 100% health as well, considering that in this video we're running the Suicide Masteries of Recoil. That was such a good matchup against Venom. 188 hits on the combo meter. So yeah, that was fantastic. Worked out very, very nice. So this is going to be the final video in the Guillotine 2099 Labyrinth series for now, man. We might return to this character in a little bit, but I've definitely uploaded, you know, a fair bit of gameplay on this champion. I think just before the release of this character, I'll probably do a Variant 3 gameplay video once they fix her degeneration in that, because she is currently bugged in Variant 3, which is a little bit annoying. So whenever she would crit, she's not degenerating, which means she's missing a lot of her damage output there. But I think Guillotine 2099, when she's working as intended, is going to be an absolute beast for Variant 3 as well, especially being a tech champion there. But yeah, ladies and gentlemen, hopefully you did enjoy some of the Labyrinth gameplay. It's been a really fun time kind of testing her against all of the fights, and I think I'm fairly confident in saying that right now I do believe that Guillotine is like the second best option overall for Labyrinth of Legends. Again, Aegon is just like too valuable with his unblockable and also ability to deal like a lot of additional damage into the block, and also the fact that he does have a very strong ability accuracy reduction when above like 500 hits on the combo meter. And if you go into Labyrinth of Legends, it's really easy to get that in a couple of fights, so you have it for like all of the fights you need it. I think when it comes to Labyrinth gameplay, I think it was Crystal Opening Whale that pretty much uploaded a solo of every single fight in Labyrinth with Aegon. So yeah, Guillotine, she does have her limits and fights that she wouldn't be able to do, such as Magneto, and does have a very bad matchup on matchups like Ant-Man and also Maestro. So yeah, unfortunately there isn't going to be any Maestro gameplay, because Guillotine being a tech character, Maestro gains all of his random buffs, so he gains the Power Flood. He can also, I think, gain Unstoppable randomly, and also Regeneration. So there's all sorts of like crazy stuff that goes on that just makes it a bit of a clown fiesta if you are fighting Maestro with a tech champion. But this was my final fight of the Labyrinth run against Civil Warrior, who is just, just really, really fun to play against a Guillotine 2099. This is actually the pre-buff version, so I don't believe he has any ability that kind of reduces your offensive ability accuracy, so you can very reliably get in, like, all that direct damage from ramping up the combo meter. So, yeah, you just absolutely slaughter this lad. It's a really, really good time. So we've got 150 additional hits on the combo. You can see all of our hits are almost dealing about 9,000 direct damage at the moment. Plus, we're going into that Assassin's range, so we're getting even more kind of damage off our basic hits and also degeneration as well. So yeah, this one is going really, really well. Her electric soul saber just feels so good toward the end of the fight, because above 100 combo hits it opens up and it's just dealing so much damage. Let me know in the comment section below if you want to see any more gameplay from Guillotine 2099 in the upcoming weeks, and also what kind of boss fights and modes of content that you'd like to see kind of this character showcased and tested in. But anyway, aside from that, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. Please do smash that like button if you enjoyed today's video. Take care, and I hope that you have an absolutely fantastic day.